Hello everyone, children, today we are going to start with our new chapter, okay? That is chapter 9, mass, means weight. In previous chapter, we have learned about length, isn't it? So, all of you take out your book number 5, page number 15. Students, as you can see, here question is, some pictures I'm given, okay? And with that pictures, some units are also given, okay? So we have to circle those units by seeing the pictures, okay? And this question is all about revision. So question given, circle the correct unit which should be used for measuring the weights of the following objects, okay? So your objects are given and the units are given. So as you can see, your units are given as kg and g. Kg means kilogram and g means gram. But in previous class, what we have learned? We have learned kilometer, meter and centimeter, isn't it? So here we are going to learn about kg and gram because this chapter is all about weight. Okay? So now you can see there are given picture of a pencil. This is a pencil. So this, whenever it is measured in kg or g, means kilogram or gram. As it is a lightweight object, so it is measured in a gram. Okay? This is a picture of an apple. So this is measured in a kg. Okay? Car. As this is a heavy object, so it is measured in a kg. Okay? Coin. Coins is also measured in gram. This is a picture of table. So, table is measured in a kg unit. Okay? So, this is a picture of a pumpkin. Pumpkin is measured kg unit. Girl, weight of a girl. It is also measured in kg. Bag. Bag is measured in a kg. Chocolate. Gram. Bat. Kg. Okay, so in this way you complete this page. Okay, now let us go to the next page. Next page given, we are familiar with the term weight. Okay, so all of you, we are familiar with the word weight. Before starting, answer the following question. So before we start, some questions are given, let us solve it. Have you ever weighed yourself? Is the same kind of machine used for weighing fruits or vegetables? So, have you ever weighed yourself? Have you seen what is your weight? Yes. Sometimes we measure our weight, isn't it? So, is the same kind of machine is weight for the weighing these fruits and vegetables? No. Okay. Number B is given. Have you ever seen a weighing machine being used for weighing very heavy things? Do you need the same kind of machine to weigh gold or silver? So, have you ever seen a weighing machine being used for weighing heavy objects? Have you seen? Yes. So, do you need the same kind of machine to weigh gold or silver? No. As gold and silver are very small, so it requires another weighing machine. Okay. So, let us learn about the devices which are used to weigh different objects. So, here you can see these are the objects. With the help of these objects, the objects are measured. Okay. The first is given devices used for measuring weight. There are different types of devices which are used for measuring weights of different objects. Okay, example pan balance, electronic weighing machine, spring balance, bathroom scale, etc. Clear? So as you can see, this is a picture of a balance, pan balance. This is measured, this is used for measuring fruits and vegetables. This is measured, this weighing machine is measured for heavy materials, heavy things, heavy objects, okay? This is measured more heavier objects. This is measured for, this is used for measuring the weight of a person, okay? And this is used for measuring fruits and vegetables, okay? So, these are the different objects which are used for measuring lighter weight objects and heavy weight objects. Okay, students? Now you can see units for measuring weight. Next topic is given, units for measuring weight. There are several units in metric system used for measuring weight, but here we will learn only about kilogram and gram. So in measuring to measure weight, there are different metric system are used, okay? But in this chapter we are going to learn about only kilogram and gram. Now let us see what is kilogram. Kilogram is written as kg, okay? This is the standard unit of weight. It is used for measuring weights of heavier objects such as man, a bag of rice, a bag of fruits, etc. Okay, so this kilogram is a standard unit of weight and it is used for measuring the heavier objects. Okay, suppose the weight of a person, weight of a bag of rice, weight a bag of fruits. So these things are measured in a standard unit of weight. Okay, and this is measured in terms of kilogram. Okay, now next is gram. It is used for measuring weights of light objects. Weights of light objects. Okay, kilogram is a standard unit of objects and gram is used for weights of light objects such as book, 2-3 tomatoes, okay, etc. Like pencil, weight of a pencil. So these things are also weighed in a gram. Gram is written as in short form as G. Okay, so it is written as G and kilogram is written as kg. Clear? Some standard measures used in our daily life. So this pictures you can see 50 gram, 100 gram, 200 gram, 500 gram, 1 kg, 2 kg, 5 kg. So these are the standard measures which is used in our daily life. Like when you go to the market to purchase something like fruits or vegetables, they will give you 200 gram, 500 gram, 1 kg, 2 kg or grocery things. So these are only weighed with the help of this standard measures. Okay, students, is it clear? Now let us go to the next page. Now as you can see, one relationship is given between units and weight. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. So with the help of this formula we are going to solve our rest of the questions. Okay, students, so all of you go through this page, whatever I have taught you just now. Okay, thank you.